Welcome back to Blackshear Stadium here in the postgame show on the campus of Prairie View A&M University. Lee Jean, Ted Dixie, Michael Burns is our videographer. Bulldogs lose today to the Prairie View A&M Panthers by a score of 33-27. Ted, it was a tough game for the Bulldogs early on, but a valiant effort to come back and try to make this a game and win it in the end.
One reason you never lay down in the Southwestern Athletic Conference, the most competitive conference in the football championship subdivision, is because you never know if that last score that someone makes is the difference maker.
Right.
Well, today we got the last two scores that we gave Prairie View ended up being the difference maker, as Lee accounts for the scoring for today.
Scoring drives went like this. Prairie View A&M on the board first, 7-0, 5 plays, 75 yards, 1 minute, 22 seconds, 21-yard touchdown pass from K.J. Black to Eddie A. Bulldogs came back, 42-yard run by Ulysses Banks, 2 plays, 48 yards, 7-7 is the score, and then it was all Prairie View A&M until the Bulldogs decided to play in the second half.
That's
Prairie
right.
View A&M on top, 14-7, 72-yard pass to Eddie A. from K.J. Black. It was an impressive pass and catch by that wide receiver.
Especially the way that ADA was able to get through, weave his way through the Bulldog defense by stiff-arming Rico Porch and Chris Fosh, separating himself from the Bulldog tacklers and lunging into the end zone.
14-7 was the score then. Bulldogs then give up another touchdown pass, 21-yard pass to Anthony Whedon. That made it K.J. Black's third touchdown pass of the day. 21-7 was the score. Then before the half, Prairie View A&M adds a field goal, a 25-yard field goal by Faggard, made it 24-7 at the half. Then in the second half, Corey Morrison gets an interception at the 2-yard line. He steps out of bounds. Bulldogs hand it off to Ulysses Banks. We fumble the football. They recover it. It's knocked out of the end zone for a safety. 26-7 is the score. On the free kick, we have to kick it off from the 20, and Anthony Whedon gets a good return to the 43-yard line of Alabama A&M. 3 plays, 43 yards, 1 minute, 10 seconds. Babers with a 4-yard run. The score at that point was 33-7, and Ted, we kind of had to look at each other and look at the team and question, now we're going to see what kind of team are we made of. Are we going to lay
That's
down,
right.
or are we going to come back down 33-7?
Are we going to compete? Are we going to have Coach Jones find out who's on his team that's ready to play football and who will lay down at the first sign of adversity? It looks like the answer is no one is going to lay down on the Bulldog football team as we make a valiant effort on a comeback trail.
We talked about we're unable to sustain any long drives. Will we put together a drive unaided by any penalties? 16 plays, 80 yards, 7 minutes, 7 seconds. Mason with a 1-yard keeper. Bulldogs come back. We get a stop. 9 plays, 85 yards, 5 minutes, 31 seconds. Another 1-yard keeper by Deontay Mason. 33-20. We went for 2 on that one, unable to convert. Then, as we throw an interception in the end zone, Prairie View brings it out. Then K.J. Black, trying to ice the game, fumbles it. Julius Pruitt with the recovery. Kevin Atkins comes on for the injured Deontay Mason. We say he's injured. We're not sure. He didn't play the last couple of minutes of the game. And Kevin Atkins finds Rashad Johnson for a 4-yard touchdown pass, 3 plays, 15 yards, 33-27. The onside kick, we failed that. And so the final score is Prairie View runs out the clock, 33-27. Ted, it was good to see Kevin Atkins come in and throw a touchdown pass. You mentioned we were going to need him. No doubt Deontay Mason is the quarterback for the Bulldogs, but anytime you can build the backup quarterback's confidence, that's huge.
And especially when thinking about having to travel. We go back home this week, folks. We'll get 2 weeks in a row on nice return trips home. But this is what is very interesting about this game. We get 23 first downs to Prairie View's 12. We get 191 yards rushing on 34 attempts. They get 97 on 27 attempts. We get 185 yards passing on 18 of 40 with 2 interceptions. Mm. They get 224 yards passing on 14 completions on 27 attempts with 1 pick. We run 74 offensive plays for 376 yards. They run 55 offensive plays for 321 yards. We win the battle of possession. 30 minutes, 53 seconds, 29 minutes, 7 seconds. We're 7 of 14 on third down conversions. They're 3 of 12. The red zone chances, we were 3 of 3 today. They were 2 of 2. That's why I say we will see Prairie View A&M again, because I'm sure that they're going to beat Alcorn State next week to continue this role, because this will be an opportunity for them to do what? Go undefeated in the SWAC.
And we have to take care of business by defeating Jackson State next week. Lewis Cruz, 1 o'clock. And then Mississippi Valley State. Ted, you look at the offensive numbers compared to A&M versus Prairie View A&M. How did we lose this game? Turnovers, two fumbles, and two interceptions.
And that's the only way you can ever just take yourself out of a football game, folks, is to turn the ball over. We ran the ball today, and we stopped the run. Deontay Mason, 12 carries, 95 yards, two touchdowns. Ulysses Banks, 15 carries, 81 yards, one touchdown. Tony Green, three carries, 15 yards. Kevin Atkins, one carry, 5 yards. On Prairie View A&M side, Donald Babers, 17 carries, 113 yards, one touchdown. Calvin Harris, 5 carries for 16 yards. Michael Jason, 1 carry minus 2 yards. KJ Black, 3 carries minus 11 yards. Deontay Mason, 16 to 34, 2 interceptions, 170 yards. KJ Black, 14 completions on 27 attempts, 1 interception, 224 yards, 3 touchdowns, and a back-breaking play to us, a 72-yard touchdown completion.
And, Ted, we go back to that one play. Deontay Mason had 95 yards rushing, but we had a 70-yard run by Deontay back for holding. That right there is the difference in the game.
That and giving up the last score. And let's not forget, Kevin Atkins comes off the field in a crucial moment in the football game with a crucial drive and goes 2 out of 4 for 15 yards and 1 touchdown.
Leading receiver today for the Bulldogs, Thomas Harris, 6 catches, 76 yards. And for Prairie View, Gabe Ose, ADI, 3 catches for 104 yards and 2 back-breaking touchdowns. Bulldogs come up short today against the Prairie View A&M Panthers, 33-27. Long bus ride home for the team. No doubt it'll be a little bit easier. Not easy because we lost, but easier because we played well in the second half. We had a chance to win this game. We just come up that much short. But when we see them in Birmingham again, we'll come up just right and win this game, maybe.
Well, let's take a point at this. That long ride home is enough for players to start analyzing and getting introspective to seeing what they can do against Jackson State next weekend so we can beat the brakes off Jackson State and then have to play Mississippi Valley State at home to clinch our chance to go to the SWAC championship game.
Bulldog,
it's 2006 Bulldog, all over again.
That's right. Bulldog fans, we need a lot of maroon and white in the stadium next week at Lewis Cruz Stadium. We haven't been home since the second or the last weekend in September. So when we come home, we want to be greeted by a lot of maroon and white.
That's right.
And cheer on this football team as they try to make it back to the SWAC championship by winning the Eastern Division. Jackson State kickoff is at 1 o'clock. You can hear all the action right here on 90.9 WJAB. From my broadcast partner, Ted Dixie, and Michael Burns, thank everyone for making us a part of the afternoon. I'm Lee Jean. We'll talk to you next Saturday, 1 o'clock, 12:30 pregame, Lewis Cruz Stadium. Bulldogs lose it today, 33-27. Have a good weekend. Enjoy Veterans Day. We thank everyone for the service of protecting this great nation. Good night, everyone.